learning. Thought. More thought. Science. You're watching Knowledge the Show with me, Lightning Rosenblatt. Now on with the show.
Hello and welcome to Knowledge the Show. I'm your host, Lightning Rosenblatt, and today we're learning about albinism.
Here are some examples of people with albinism.
What is albinism, you ask? It occurs when a genetic defect disables the body in the production of melanin, causing little to no pigment to exist in the skin, hair, and eyes. A lot of you are probably asking me right now, Lightning Rosenblatt, what's melanin? Well, I'll tell you. Melanin is a natural substance in the skin, right? It's produced by cells in the skin called melanocytes.
Here's a diagram.
It gives color to your skin, your hair, and your eyes. It also protects you from the sun. This is why people in hotter regions of the earth, like India and Africa, tend to have darker skin, because they've got more melanin for sun protection. It's also why albinos are really sensitive to light, because they don't have any protection. A lot of you are probably asking me right now, hey, Lightning Rosenblatt, how do I tell if I have albinism? Not to worry, little pixies. The symptoms of albinism include extremely white skin, white or pinkish hair, and pink or reddish eyes. Also, most albinos have impaired vision. They could be nearsighted or farsighted, but most often they're just very sensitive to light because of their lack of protection from melanin in their eyes.
Remember, albinism's genetic, which means it can't be caught. Unless you have a family history of albinism, you probably don't have it. You can't get it from an albino sneezing on you, or bleeding on you, or rubbing up against you, or anything like that. Can't be caught. It's genetic.
Alright, you can also get tested. 1. A doctor can diagnose albinism based on the appearance of your skin, hair, and eyes. 2. An ophthalmologist can perform an electroretinogram test.
Testing your retinas.
Such a test can reveal vision problems that relate to albinism. The most accurate way, 3, is genetic testing. It's the most accurate way to diagnose albinism and its type. It's really helpful if the patient getting tested has a family history of albinism, and also it's useful for certain populations known to get the disease. Alright, now, there are two main types of albinism when it comes to types. These are the most common types. Type 1, oculocutaneous albinism, affects the skin, hair, and eye color. Type 2, ocular albinism, mostly affects the eyes, but still can slightly off-color the hair and skin. Now, I can't stress this enough. Most albinos have extremely bad vision difficulties. Many are even considered legally blind.
Legally blind. I'm good.
Now, besides those two forms of albinism I just told you about, there are a bunch more that are a lot rarer. The most frequent of these rarer kinds is Hermansky-Pudlak syndrome. An albino with Hermansky-Pudlak syndrome can experience a lot of problems with bleeding and bruising. They can also be a lot more susceptible to diseases that affect the bowels and the lungs. Ouch. Now, as people with this syndrome tend to develop a lot more physical problems than just their impaired vision, their life expectancy tends to be a lot shorter than those of regular albinos. Now for one of my favorite parts of the show, fun facts and trivia.
You know, not all albinos are human. Any animal can be albino. Reptiles, birds, mammals, any animal.
Examples.
In fact, the Barcelona Zoo had an albino gorilla up until a few years ago when it died of skin cancer due to its lack of protection from melanin. Also, rock musician Edgar Winter and reggae artist Yellowman both have albinism. Have you seen The Matrix Reloaded, The Princess Bride, or The Da Vinci Code? Of course you have. Those are timeless classics. All of them. Anyway, all those movies have characters who are albino in them. Alright guys, that's it for this week's episode of Knowledge, the show. I hope you guys enjoy learning, because whether you do or not, you just did! Alright, I'm Lightning Rosenblatt, and remember, wear your sunblock no matter how much melanin you produce, or else you might end up like a certain Spanish gorilla I know.